It is finally here, the NBA trade deadline this Thursday, February 6th, less than 48 hours away, and it feels like half the league is on the trading block. You've got a lot of big names out there, a lot of rumors. We're going to break down all the rumors. You got names like D'Angelo Russell. Could he be heading to Minnesota to link up with Karl Anthony Towns? You got names like Clint Capella. There's been rumors that the Houston Rockets and Daryl Morey, they're aggressively shopping Clint Capella. Teams like the Atlanta Hawks, the Boston Celtics, Tristan Thompson, Kevin Love, a lot of rumors about them. But we're going to start with the Memphis Grizzlies. The Memphis Grizzlies, they're sitting at 25-25, 8th seed in the Western Conference. They've won 7 of their last 10 games, and there's been a lot of talk. Will Andre Iguodala, the former NBA Finals MVP, will he rejoin the Grizzlies instead of getting traded, instead of getting bought out? Well, that is not going to happen anytime soon. Following the Grizzlies' 96-82 win last night over the Pistons, Dylan Brooks called out Andre Iguodala in the postgame. He says, "I can't wait till we find a way to trade him so we can play him and show him really what Memphis is about." Shots fired by Dylan Brooks. And then in the wake of those comments, his former teammate, Andre Iguodala's former teammate, Steph Curry, chimed in. It was a little subtle, but he goes to Instagram and he shares an image of Andre Iguodala after the finals, and he has that shush emoji. And then Rachel Nichols, she posted that picture on Twitter, and then she says, "And now Steph is chiming in." And then right underneath that, Ja Morant, he quickly posted a picture of Kevin Durant, and he's holding that Finals MVP. He's got his own shush emoji, his own little shrug emoji, and then he doesn't even delete it. He says, "Hey, Curry got a ring. Oh yeah, 100 emoji." And then he follows that up with, "LOL, deleted for what? If you scroll down my Twitter, you'll see me talking about Curry a lot. Probably some other players too. I was a fan and still a fan, but I ain't scared of him." And a couple cry face laughing emojis. It's clear that the Grizzlies young core, they've had enough with Iguodala deciding not to suit up for the franchise at all this season. Look, Iguodala is making $17 million to sit out of action while the Grizzlies are trying to facilitate a trade with another team. They've said they're not going to buy him out. They want some assets for Andre Iguodala, but it's clear right now they are not going to part ways with him for nothing. They will not buy him out. And if you're the Memphis Grizzlies, this is exactly what you do. You want to get some assets for Andre Iguodala. You're not going to let him walk. You're not going to buy him out, because what is he going to do? He's going to go to the Lakers, the Clippers. He's going to join a contender, and you're going to get nothing. You need to get some assets for a guy that you're paying $17 million for. And according to Shams Charkhania of The Athletic, the Miami Heat, second in the Eastern Conference, one of the surprise teams, one of the elite teams in the NBA this year, they're willing to make a move for Andre Iguodala. Here's Shams Charkhania on the Miami Heat's interest on the former Finals MVP.
"Sources tell me that the Heat have emerged as a suitor for Andre Iguodala. Besides the bad discussions, no deal has been consummated yet. There's several factors here to monitor. One, will the sides agree on the potential players and picks involved? Two, will another team also get engaged here with Memphis between now and Thursday's deadline? And three, will Andre Iguodala's appetite be ready for a team like Miami or somewhere else? You know, he's made clear to some people close to him that he could be prepared to sit out the season if he's not traded to a destination, potentially closer to home on the West Coast."
So if I'm the Miami Heat, I really would make some moves. Look, yes, the Milwaukee Bucks, they're dominant, but the Sixers, they've been disappointing. The Boston Celtics, if they make some trades here, because look, they're not going to be able to get it done with this current roster. Yes, Bam Adebayo, he's had a breakout season, made the All-Star team. Last night, Jimmy Butler, 38 points. He's been phenomenal all year long, but they need to bring in some other guys, and you bring in the championship pedigree of Andre Iguodala. Maybe you flip something like Justice Winslow for him. And another trade I would like to see them do is for Drew Holiday. Drew Holiday, he fits that Heat culture with the defense, the discipline. Imagine Jimmy Butler and Drew Holiday as your perimeter defenders. Those are two lockdown players, players that bring it in the playoffs. Look what Drew Holiday did to Damian Lillard a couple years ago when they were in the playoffs and he was with the Pelicans. Drew Holiday is an elite player in this league. He's an elite two-way player in this league. And if I'm the Miami Heat, I would strongly consider giving up Tyler Hero for Drew Holiday. He's already under contract, and it puts them in this win-now mode. Imagine you bring in Drew Holiday Holiday and Andre Iguodala with Bam and Jimmy Butler. That is a team that can compete in the East. They can make things interesting with the Milwaukee Bucks. And yes, Tyler Hero looks like he's going to be an elite shooter in this league, but Drew Holiday is an elite player in this league. If you have to give him up to get a player of his caliber, you do that. Look, how much longer does Pat Riley want to do this? You never know. And he probably wants to win this year. And Jimmy Butler, he's got a couple elite years left. Not a lot of elite years, maybe 2-3 elite years. You bring in Drew Holiday, you bring in Andre Iguodala. I'm telling you, if I'm a Heat fan, I would push those young players out to get those veterans in, and I would make a run at this title. So I'm telling you, make those moves this year, and the Milwaukee Bucks, the Philadelphia 76ers, the Boston Celtics, they're going to be feeling the heat. Thanks for watching the Get More Sports YouTube channel. My name is Doug McCain. You can follow me at DMAC_LA. And for all the hottest sports content in the game, be sure to hit that subscribe button, hit that notification button, and most importantly, give me all your takes right down below in the comments section. I want all your takes right down below in the comments section. And for all the hottest and latest sports news, head over to GetMoreSports.com.